Hello friends, welcome you all to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install and configure KVM kernel based virtual machine on Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9 to create practice lab for RHCSA and RHCE exam on your personal computer or laptop. I was practicing that same kind of lab environment on my system and cleared RHCSA RHCE exam in first attempt. I am going to share all my tips and tricks with you in this series step by step. To understand this topic clearly, you need to watch RHEL 9 installation tutorial video first. Please click on the above I button. I have divided this RHCSA and RHCE practice lab creation tutorial video into two parts. In this first part, I am describing you how to active virtualization on your system through motherboard, VirtualBox and VMware with Windows setting, then KVM installation, then virtual machine creation on RHEL 9. Let's start. You need to check your BIOS first. If their virtualization is not enabled, enable it. At the time of system boot, press your appropriate key to get in the BIOS. This key could be any, typically from F1 to F12 or delete, and enable virtualization mode. In my system BIOS, it's called SVM or Secure Virtual Machine mode. It could be different on your BIOS. If your RHEL 9 installation on a physical system, then that would be enough step for you. But if your RHEL 9 installation on a virtual box, then open Oracle Virtual Box Manager, select the VM, click on Setting. Select system, click on processor, tick the both checkboxes and click on OK. For VMware, right click on VM heading tab, click on setting, choose processors, check the box beside virtualize Intel VT-X/EPT or AMD-V/RVI must be checked. You could tick the second option also. And if virtual machine not getting started after doing all of this, then open run from your base OS Windows 10 or Windows 11, type appwiz.cpl, hit enter, click on turn Windows feature on or off. Two options must be unticked. First option, Hyper-V, and second option, Windows Sandbox. Okay, let's start our today's topic. This is our Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9 system. By this command, we can assure that this system is compatible with virtualization. Or you can use this command also. Okay. Our system is qualified the virtualization compatibility criteria. Now, I am going to install virtualization packages on this system. Okay, done. After installation, you have to enable it by this command. Now, click on Activities. Click on Show Applications. Click on Virtual Machine Manager. Type user's password for authentication and hit enter. This is our Virtual Machine Manager. Click on the first icon to create a new virtual machine. I am going to install through first option, ISO image file. By default, it is selected. Click on Forward. Click on Browse. Click on Browse Local. Select Downloads. Select RHEL 9 ISO image file which I have kept here. Click on Open button. Click on Forward. Tick the box and click on Yes. Minimum system requirement for RHEL 9: 2GB RAM or more, 1GB single or multiple CPU, 20GB hard disk space. But I have sufficient RAM. That's why I would prefer to give 4GB RAM for better performance. CPUs 2 core will be nice. Click on Forward. 20GB disk space will be perfect. Click on Forward. Type a name for your VM. Server will be an appropriate name for RHCSA and RHCE practice lab. Tick the box beside Customize configuration before install. Click on Finish. Click on Add hardware. I am going to add another disk for our server VM. 5GB will be sufficient according to exam, but I would prefer 10GB for home practice. Click on Finish. Click on Begin installation. click on Allow. Press up arrow key, select Install Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9.0 and hit Enter. Select your language, click on Continue. Click on the installation destination. Select 20GB disk space. Storage configuration automatic. Click on Done. Click on Software selection. Let it be as it is. Click on Done. Click on Root password. Give a password as per your choice. Tick the checkbox beside Allow root SSH login with password. Click on Done. Click on User creation. Give its name Server. Need to tick both checkboxes. Give a password as per your choice. Click on Done. Click on Begin installation. Installation process has been started. Click on Reboot system. Our VM server is ready. Power off this VM for now. I am going to copy server VM through Virtual Machine Manager. Right click on the server VM, select clone option. Untick second disk which we have created with 10GB disk space. Only installation disk has to tick. Give its name desktop. Click on clone. I have excluded second disk but somehow it's not detached yet. Okay, no problem. I will show you how to add or remove hardware of VM after few steps. Click on OK. Cloning process has been started. Our desktop VM is now ready. Select server VM. Click on open. We can add or remove hardware from this VM through this section. This is disk 1 or installation disk of server VM and this is disk 2 of server VM. Now select the desktop VM and click on open. Second disk which is a part of server VM, and if I keep this disk with both VMs then we cannot run both VMs simultaneously. So select disk 2 and click on remove. Click on delete. Now desktop VM has only one disk. But if we want to add another disk for this VM, click on add hardware. Storage option has been already selected. Define disk capacity 10GB will be fair enough. Click on finish. Now desktop VM has its own disk too with 10GB space. Next part of this tutorial video I will show you how to write script to create custom command and make environment like RHCSA and RHCE exam lab on Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9. Hope you like this video, please like, share and subscribe my channel to boost me up to create more knowledgeable videos. Thank you.